Next question, and here they are asking which of the following is the key for R? Assuming the relation R is E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, and N. These are the attributes in the relation. And these are the functional dependencies which are given. EF determines G, F determines IJ. Then we have EH determines KL. Then we have K determines M. Then we have L determines N. So these are the functional dependencies which are given. Now they're asking, what is the key for the relation R? What is the key for relation R? So option A is EF, option B is EFH, option C is EFHKL, and option D is E only. Okay, see, I can take these options one by one and I can find the closure of these options, but there's one more shortcut of identifying what is the key for the relation. Is you look at the functional dependencies which are given. So these are the functional dependencies which are given. In all these functional dependencies, look at the right hand side of every functional dependency, right? This is the right hand side. Now in this right hand side, check out what are the attributes which are not present, right? Out of all these, what are the attributes which are not present? So G is present, I is present, J is present, K is present, L is present, M is present, N is present. That means there are three attributes which are not present, that is E, F, and H. So any key or any key which should be there in the relation, they should contain E, F, and H. Therefore, I can directly eliminate the option number A, as well as I can directly eliminate the option number D. Now we are left with two options, that is option number B and option number C. So option number B is only made up of E, F, H. So let us try to take the closure of E, F, H. E, F, H closure. So you can see from this functional dependencies, E can determine E itself, that is trivial. F can determine F itself, and H can determine H itself. These things are trivial. Now you can see with the help of EF, I can determine G. Yes. With the help of F, I can determine I and J. So I and J will be there. With the help of E and H, I can determine K and L. With the help of K, I can determine M. With the help of L, I can determine N. Therefore, if I take the closure of EFH, I will be able to determine all the attributes in this relation. Therefore, EFH is a key, or you can say it is a candidate key as well as it is a super key. It is a key, candidate key as super key, right? Now, if you take EFHKL, now with this also, you will be able to determine all the attributes, but this is not a candidate key. It is a super key. Why? Because it is containing K and L. Without having K and L, there's a proper subset of this which is EFH, which can determine everything. Therefore, it is a super key, but it is not a candidate key. Okay, therefore the answer is option number B. So it is a previous year question which they asked. Okay, now let us take the next question. So next question, which is like this. We have the following relation: R A comma B comma C comma D comma E comma H. This is the relation which is given, and these are the functional dependencies which are given. A can determine B, BC can determine D, E can determine C, and D can determine A. Now they are asking what are the candidate keys for the relation R? For the relation R, option A, it is AE comma BE. Option B, it is AE comma BE comma DE. Option C, it is AEH comma BEH comma BCH. And option D, it is AEH comma BEH comma DEH. So these are the options which are given, and this is also a previous year question. So what is the shortcut of solving this? Look at the right hand side of every production and identify what are the attributes which are not present. So B is present, D is present, C is present, and A is present. That means E and H are two attributes which are not present in the right hand side of these production. Therefore, any key which is not containing E and H, that will never be a candidate key. Therefore, option number A and option number B, we can directly eliminate. We can directly eliminate option number A and option number B. Now, let us take EH closure. Now, if you find EH closure, with the help of E, we can identify E itself. With the help of H, I can identify H itself because it is trivial. Now, with the help of E, I can determine C. With the help of H, I cannot determine anything else. Therefore, EH closure is only EHC. We are not able to determine anything else with EH closure. That means EH can never be a candidate key. Now, we'll try to add other attributes to EH so that we can try to identify what are the keys we can find, right? So let us take the first option. It is AEH. So if I add A with EH, then let us take the closure AEH. EH is no, this is trivial. With the help of A, I can determine B. With the help of E, I can determine C. With the help of BC, I can determine D. And with the help of D, I can find A. Therefore, you can identify each and every attribute here. Therefore, AEH is a candidate key, as well as it is also a super key. Let us take the next option, that is BEH. See, AEH and BEH is common in both of them. So obviously they must be the candidate key, but let us take BEH closure. BEH is trivial. With the help of B, I can not determine anything. With the help of E, I can determine C. With the help of BC, I can determine D. With the help of D, I can determine A. Therefore, I can determine everything. Therefore, it is a candidate key as well as it is a super key. Okay. Now, let us take the next option. Next option is saying BCH. In these two, only these two options are changing. You can clearly see this BCH is not at all containing EH. I could have, instead of solving this, I could have directly said that option number C is wrong, because here in this case, it do not have E. So, directly option number D is correct. I don't actually have to solve this question. I just have to check the right-hand side of every production or every functional dependency, and you have to see what are the things which are not present. So, EH is present here. EH is present here, but EH is not present here. Therefore, this can never be a super key, or okay, this can never be a candidate key as well as super key. Therefore, option C is actually ruled out. Option number D is correct, but still in option number D, let us identify DEH. If I take DH closer, then DEH is trivial. With the help of E, I can determine C. With the help of D, I can determine A, right? And with the help of A, I can determine B. Therefore, I can determine everything. So DEH is a candidate key. Okay, so now let us take next question on this.